championship belongs to the Los Angeles Lakers.
Hello, Lakers Nation. Sean Davis here for LakersNation.com, your home for everything Lakers. The Los Angeles Lakers are trying to build this roster back up to championship-level contention under new head coach Darvin Ham. But one of the biggest things we're going to have to fix is the apparent lack of depth at the wing position last season. So in today's video, we're going to take a look at some of the free agency targets that I've listed for the Lakers at the wing position here. And really quickly, a fair warning that there are not a lot of good, serviceable guys that can step in either at the end of your rotation or to fill out the roster or to actually contribute at major minutes. So some of these names I'm really digging down deep trying to find, so bear with me on that. But I also don't think free agency is the only way the Lakers can add depth at the wing. That's why I think the draft and the rumors are the Lakers are going to buy 2 second-round picks, so that's going to be crucial as well. But before we get into all of that, a quick reminder, please do subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Ring that notification bell as well so you can stay up to date with our latest content. It's going to be a very busy offseason for your Los Angeles Lakers, so you want to stay in the know with our latest news and coverage. So let's hop into this one. Number five, let's go Gary Clark. I know this one is so random, so out of the dirt, so bear with me here. But I think this kind of makes sense a little bit. Gary Clark, athletic. He is a little young. He is younger than a lot of players like on the roster last year. He's only 27 years old. Can step in. He's been a better defender. I think he's gotten better as a defender over time. I think that's why we're seeing him play a little bit more in the NBA nowadays. He could shoot the three ball well. He shot it really, really well last season. He's had a couple of seasons where he shot around league average. He's had a couple of seasons where he didn't shoot the three ball well, but I think he's right around a league average shooter. And he'll honestly be an end-of-the-bench rotation guy that, you know, could step in and in garbage time or just to fill out the end of your roster. I think you just want some depth towards the back end of your roster, and you go get Gary Clark. I am all right with that. 6'6", 225, I'm all right with that. You'll grab Gary Clark. Number four, let's go Rodney Hood here. Rodney Hood, he played for the Clippers last year and the Milwaukee Bucks. He's a free agent. Now, you are really banking and hoping that Rodney Hood is done with all the injury concerns because he's been really, really banged up. He hasn't played a total of over 70 games or more since 2018-19. So, and that's honestly the last time we saw Rodney Hood be really, really good and actually have a solid impact on the game was when he was last healthy in 2018-2019. So if you go back to that, you can get that version of Rodney Hood again, who was still a pretty solid defender. Now, again, that is a few years back, but if you're hoping that he's cleared of the injury concerns, he is a good three-point shooter. He's shooting for a career under 37% from three. And like you look throughout his career, he really hasn't proved he was ever a bad shooter. He's a really good three-point shooter, especially when healthy, who's a good defensive player. And hopefully you can get some of that value from the defensive end from Rodney Hood back if he's healthy and you're pairing him on the floor potentially with a guy like Anthony Davis. Because sometimes you see guys who have bad defensive seasons and battle through injuries, they come back, you pair them with good defensive players, a great one in Anthony Davis, their value on that end of the floor, in Rodney Hood's case in this point, Rodney Hood's defensive value could go back up, and I think that could be monumental to the Lakers. If not, it's just another solid end of the rotation guy who you could throw in case of a break glass, in case of emergency type of situation there. So for a veteran minimum, I'm all right with getting Rodney Hood. Number three, let's go get Daniel House Jr. And again, some of these names, you guys are like, what the heck is Sean talking about? But again, the free agents they pull is so just like bare minimum, is nothing there. So I'm really pulling some names out here. But this is a name the Lakers have been linked to around the buyout market season. But this is a guy, a 3-and-D player who didn't really shoot the three ball well after like Harden and Chris Paul left Houston. But then he refound that shot and when he got to Utah this season. And I think that is what is he gets easier shots from three when you have dynamic playmakers and shot creators like Harden, Donovan Mitchell, LeBron James, potentially Anthony Davis as well, Russell Westbrook, who can get downhill and find guys. So Daniel House Jr., a 3-and-D wing, and also it's no coincidence that Daniel House played better defense on better defensive teams. He looked pretty good this year as well. His lowest defensive rating, lower meaning good, since he was on those Houston Rockets teams this year with the Utah Jazz. Daniel House, a guy that we've been linked to, I think this makes a lot of sense for the Lakers. You go get Daniel House. I think that would help your team. And again, another one, if it doesn't work out, he could be a break glass in case of emergency type of case. And I do think Daniel House could contribute maybe 12 minutes here and there, can knock down some threes, can play some defense for you. I think this is the type of player the Lakers need. Again, he's only 29 as well, who just turned 29 recently. So happy belated birthday to Daniel House Jr. I like this fit. We were talking about this a lot during the buyout market season. It makes a lot of sense in my opinion. Now we're going to two guys that are your tax pyramid level exception options. So I'm not even going to use my other veteran minimum because I don't think there are very many options. But let's start off with TJ Warren. And this is the high risk, high reward option here. You go get TJ Warren for the tax pyramid level exception. You give him the Kendrick Nunn deal. Trevor Lane has recently proposed this as well. 2 years, about $12 million. But instead of the second year being a player option, you try to do a team option somehow to get some team control so you can either let him go if he just does not play well or is on the floor enough this season, or you extend him and he doesn't get the chance to walk. But TJ Warren, another one where you're really banking on him being actually healthy. But TJ Warren, when he was healthy in that bubble run, man, he had a really nice defensive season, or a good one anyway. He's not an elite defender, but a serviceable defender that can knock down the three and be a secondary playmaker and shot maker. And it's two really healthy seasons, 2018-19 and 19-20. He shot 42.8% from three and 40.3% from three. That is what the Lakers need on this roster, a guy that can hit threes and be serviceable defensively. I don't think it's that hard. I think the guys that are there are not that great, but I don't think the blueprint, for the Lakers is that complicated. I think they know what they need to look for from wings, and so far, for the most part, I think I've found guys that can hit threes and play defense. The defense is a little bit more sketchy for some of these guys, but you go get TJ Warren. I like this one, but the more safe, not conservative, but the safer bet, and I think the better fit, honestly, is Otto Porter Jr. Talking about a guy that's been so crucial to that Warriors team on both ends of the floor. His spacing, and not only his spacing to be able to hit threes, but to put the ball down the floor, one dribble pull up, going either way. And then defensively as well, his versatility and switchability as well really helps that Warriors defense. Not saying he's like Draymond Green defender, Andrew Wiggins level defender, but his ability to be switchy and his IQ really helps that Warriors team. You give me Otto Porter Jr., me and Trevor Lane will be happy about that. Lakers Nation, comment down below. Are you interested in any of these guys, or do you think all these guys are just not good and they won't help the Lakers? Comment down below. What do you guys want the Lakers to do in this offseason? Comment that down below as well. And as always, subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Ring that post notification bell as well. Until next time, guys, Sean Davis here for LakersNation.com. Stay safe. I'll see you guys next time. Peace out.